Desert. My name is Ryan Weber, and I'm one of the adjunct professors of low brass here at Bemidji State University, and we're so glad you're choosing to spend part of your Tuesday night with us. That first piece we played was called War March for the Priests. It's a not well-known, but it's become a staple in the trombone choir repertoire by Felix Mendelssohn. He wrote it for a stage production, Athelia, and it was originally for chorus and piano, but he has since orchestrated it for full orchestra, and we made it even better by turning it into a trombone choir arrangement. And so it's a great piece, and we've had a lot of fun working on it. So I'm going to turn it over to the next piece. It's my colleague, Professor Curtis Olson.
So from war to Christmas, these next two pieces are Christmas carols, and they're ancient Christmas carols, as you can see from the title of the pieces in the program, but they're arranged by Michael Pretorius. Michael Pretorius lived from 1571 to 1621. He wrote a treatise on music. He was a very active musician, a very active writer, but he wrote a treatise called Syntagma Musicum in 1619, and we still use that treatise, that volume, those volumes, to see what musical life was really like in those times. But he arranged these pieces, you know, before he died, so it was before 1621. These are his arrangements. Richard Myers arranged these for trombones. He was the principal trombone player for the Buffalo Philharmonic for many years, now retired. So here's Christmas carols. The first one's Lo How a Rose. It refers to the Virgin Mary. She's blooming, right, at the Christmas time. And the other one, the Dolce Jubilo, which I'm saying wrong. But I'm not a very good Latin speaker. That means good Christian men rejoice.
Thank you.
that one of those pieces, the last piece, was in the worst possible key for trombone players, B major. Nobody plays, nobody writes in B major, but Richard Myers did. And he did a great job for A sharps and everything. The next piece we're going to do is Passacaglia in C minor. This is a real standard in trombone octet and trombone choir repertoire. It was written in 1961 It was written by J.S. Bach and written by everybody for orchestra, for band, and now for trombone choir in 1961. Don Hesperger was the conductor of the East Berlin Ensemble, and he was also a trombone player. He wrote this 8-part piece for trombone choir, and it's a fantastic arrangement. Like I said, this is standard. If you equate this to Beethoven 5 for orchestra, that'd be a pretty good comparison. And here's Passacaglia in C minor.
Thank you.
While they're setting up for the next piece, this is a quintet, a trombone quintet, not a very common number of trombones to play together. We usually play in twos or duets is fine, threes in orchestra, fours in quartet, and then 8, 12, and that's about it for a trombone choir. But this is five, a strange number. Arranged by Michael Halberstam. This is Jesu meine Freude, Jesus my joy. And it's a happy piece that doesn't sound real happy, but it's in minor, but it ends happy at the end. So that's hopefully it works that way. This is actually a motet with the cantus firmus. The cantus firmus is dee-da-dee-da-dee-da, it goes like that, and it repeats that. That is going on all the time in modified version, elongated, shortened, different ranges, different volumes. You'll hear that all the time. Listen for that tune, and you'll know what the motet is about. It's originally, of course, for voice, but it's always better on trombone. Sorry, voice people. It's not always better, but sometimes better. In this case, maybe. So, here's the Jesu meine Freude.
piece on the program is by Ray Premru. He was a well-known bass trombonist and composer. He studied at the Eastman School of Music, and he played professionally for many years. If you're familiar with Beatles, he played on some of their records. Frank Sinatra, a lot of the great classic recordings. This next piece you're going to hear is a quartet called In Memoriam, and it was written as a tribute to a friend who passed away unexpectedly. And it's got some really unique harmonies, and it's a very beautiful tribute. Please enjoy In Memoriam. Thank you. While we're getting set up for the next piece, I share a little bit more information about it. The next piece we're playing is actually based on one of the first symphonies for wind band. It's by Hector Berlioz. Berlioz best known for works such as Symphonie Fantastique, and he has some opera overtures and some other concert works. But he was also commissioned to write one of the first symphonies for band. It's called the Funeral Symphony, and it's in three movements, and it's what we are playing today is a transcription of the second movement, or the funeral oration. And what does remain the same with the original is the solo voice for trombone. He borrowed an unused aria from one of his operas and put it in this work, but instead, rightfully so, that trombone would represent the work better, and so he gave it to the trombone. And so we are going to do an arrangement for trombone and trombone ensemble. And I'm pleased to feature Tim Rorick on this piece. Tim is a senior this year. He'll be graduating with plans to go on to grad school and eventual plans to hopefully play in an orchestra or an opera pit in the future. He's been very heavily involved in the music department here, playing in all the ensembles, and outside of the university, you can hear him playing with many orchestras and musical theater pits, and it's really been a treat working with him on this piece. Please welcome Tim Rorick to the stage.
Thank you.
give one more round of applause for Tim. So the next piece we're doing, you might not recognize the name Backstead, but I'm pretty sure you'll recognize the tune. If you're familiar with The Planets by Gustav Holst, the middle movement, Jupiter, has this beautiful chorale, which Holst borrowed and wrote and put into Jupiter itself. And then it was set to text and is now also known as the Backstead Hymn. And so the setting we're playing tonight, while it's based on this original tune, is the original setting itself. It's going to take the melody and you're going to hear it manipulated and transformed into the different section. And it's written by Thomas Sugar, professor of trombone at Capital University. And we were fortunate to have him out here last spring. We played some of his original compositions. And when researching more of his music, I knew this is a piece we have to do with our ensemble. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
thank you for coming to our concert tonight. This is the Bemidji Community and University Trombone Choir. How many cities of the size of Bemidji have a trombone choir? I don't know of any other ones of this size. So I think it's great. And it's really fun working with these people, dedicated people to come in and do this and play a lot of high notes and in D major. Can't forget that. So the last piece, thank you for coming. Thank you so much. Wonderful audience. Last piece we're going to play is Superman. How many of us don't know John Williams or who John Williams is? John Williams is basically the Beethoven of the modern composer world. His music is played more than maybe Beethoven in orchestras. Every orchestra, huge orchestra, major orchestras, regional orchestras, local orchestras, they play his music every year. Raiders of the Lost Ark, Star Wars, Harry Potter, Jaws, Cowboys, everything. He's written so much amazing music. This is just one of them. We hope you like Superman for 12 trombones or 8 trombones, I forget. A lot of trombones.